So what do you think about the interplanetary sort of idea, right? That we need to, as a species, be on these multiple planets. I mean,
Look, I go back and forth, and I was in Oslo, Norway, I guess in last year, 2019, with a lady who's going to be one of the first astronauts from South Africa. Wonderful, wonderful woman. But we had a little debate because I'm like, look, if it's going to cost 20, 30, $50 billion to get to Mars, I think we should take that money and invest it in the planet we've fucked up already, frankly, right? Like, imagine if all the environmental projects, all of the social projects, imagine if you took that much money and you put it to there, right? And that's a super Austin hippie thing to say, right? But my point was this is, I made a joke that I think, that it is highly probable that everybody on a first flight dies in the cold vacuum of space, right? Like, it's extremely dangerous journey. And she made an argument that was very well put, very articulate. Love or Death, it was about what we, the discoveries we'll get out of that, kind of that Apollo example I gave. 100% no argument against that. But if we start spreading across the universe in the way that you just described, I have to stop and question, are we a virus? Because what a virus does is it goes into a host like Earth, it uses up all the resources, and then it moves on to a new one.
Yeah.
And so if we're not going to take care of the planet we have, and we're not going to fix it, are we a virus? It's totally cool. Maybe we are. Maybe we are the best virus, right? The most accomplished one. But that's kind of where my head goes is like, hell yeah, I would fly to space tomorrow. Like, literally, Elon could strap me inside of a SpaceX rocket tomorrow. I want to go to space. I just want to go to orbit, right? Just I 100% want that experience in my lifetime and hope I get it. But when you talk about, this colonization of the solar system,
Yeah.
you have to stop and ask yourself, like, we haven't done a really good job of managing this planet. So I'm kind of wondering what we need at least some thought into, like, how do we not do to Mars what we've done there? That would be awesome. Because there'll be some resource found there. There'll be some discovery. It'll be a jumping off point to other things. That's kind of where my head goes. And by the way, I don't like that my head goes there because I love space. I wanted to be an astronaut. I love space. I'll go to space. Sign me up. Hell, I might even take that first trip to Mars. I mean, I'm fascinated by all things, explorations in space. We have not done a great job of managing the resources we've been given here where we live now. And I think, man, if you could just do a one-for-one grant or something, for every dollar we spend on going to Mars, just spend a dollar on the oceans or freaking that we, terraforming our soil here to get it more nutrient dense for food or something. And I'm no environmental expert, but I can think of a million things that, it doesn't take more than a quick just go to any news page. There's always a story about the weather patterns changing or this or the something. It's clear, even if you're a climate denier at this point, that like we've done some pretty irreparable damage to the planet.
There's no question. I completely agree. I'll make two points here. That I think. I heard Neil deGrasse Tyson talk about this, and he sort of made your point basically of like, why are we going to go to Mars if we could spend that money on fixing our own planet, right? He said, well, if we have the technology to go to Mars and terraform it, why wouldn't we just terraform our own planet, right? Again, and we'd be fine or whatever. And the sec my second point is kind of contradictory to that. Which is also a point I've heard Neil deGrasse Tyson make, which is sort of this cave theory, sort of thing of back in the day when humans were, first whatever on the planet, right? Which is the, well, don't go outside the cave. You could get hurt, right? Don't go on the other side of that hill. Get you.
Look,
So,
that's never,
I don't know.
yeah.
Does that work? Does that apply? I don't know. I see.
It's never stopped any real explorer, right? And I think that's the point is you have people are different. And so you have people that are explorers and they're like, we got to get to Mars. And you have people that are environmentalists and they're like, can we fix this first? And you have people in between. Look, it's a point of contingency, right? There's no problem with that. I just think it'd be nice to,
I think both.
And if we go to Mars, maybe we find stuff, building to go on that journey that helps fix some of the stuff on Earth, right? That was kind of the argument in Norway. And that's perfectly fine argument. I'd like to see it maybe written down in a plan somewhere or some kind of like actual collaboration of, hey, we're going to make all these discoveries and building all the stuff we need to get to Mars. And here's how we're going to share them with people to improve things on Earth or whatever, like, you know, a little bit more of a formalized process. Because I also worry about, you know, yeah, NASA's participating, sort of, but, you know, the private flight sector, whether it's Elon, Bezos, or, Richard, you know, Branson, who's obviously the cooler, hipper of all of those choices. Although Jeff Bezos is jacked now. I don't know if you've seen the picture.
I've seen him. He is jacked. It looks weird.
Yeah, it's like, whoa, what happened? But he's super jacked. Okay, super jacked. And Elon's super cool. And I watched a Neuralink thing the other day or whatever. It's like Richard Branson is clearly the coolest of billionaires going to space, without a doubt, right? He's like, here's a naked model on my back. Look, I just partied with all these rock stars. You know, at that time, Prince and I pontificated about the universe or whatever. He was like, yeah, that guy right there. Like, if you have to pick some one of those to be like, I wouldn't mind being that guy, it's like, that all sounds great. He basically just seems to run around the world trying to solve problems and has a party, and in that party, the problem's being solved, and then there's a party to celebrate that being solved. Like, I don't know. He's super, super awesome.